Hi everyone, welcome back. I've got something super, super exciting today. So imagine having access to all of the big LLMs, all the big large language models. Imagine being able to use your company data in a secure way and being comfortable with it. Imagine having something that's really cost effective for your business. Well, today I'm bringing you a world exclusive. This is the Collective by Whitespace. Let's get into it. So the Collective by Whitespace is a game-changing platform, in my view. It gives you access to multiple LLMs. It gives you access to LLMs that are secure, that you can use within your businesses. You can use APIs, etc. You can create your own GPTs using Llama or ChatGPT or whatever. And you can do all of that within a cost-effective way of running your business. And today, you can even get a free trial on using Collective for your own business. Just have to sign up, absolutely free, and you can try it out. So I've been working with the guys at Whitespace for a couple of years now. They're friends, and I know they've been developing this, and I know they've been using it, and I've had access to it over the last 6 or 8 months while they've been developing it. And I offered to do this video to expose it to the world. They're not paying me for it. They're quite happy for me to identify those areas for development that there might be in the software, which there are. But I think this is really an opportunity for businesses to make that leap into AI, to do it in a secure and safe way, and not to break the bank as well, which is also really important. So let's jump in, let's have a look, and let's find out what the Collective is all about. Okay, so here we are in the Collective, and I'll put a link down below. It's not an affiliate link, I'm not getting paid for it. I'll put a link down below where you can register and try this for free for 30 days for your business. That's it. You can walk away at the end of that. They're not going to take any money off you. You can set it up, have a go, have a play, see whether this works for your industry and in your business, absolutely free. Okay, so let's start by just having a quick look around the Collective. Okay, so let's jump in. You start in the browser. It's very simple, and you see up at the top it says the Collective. You've got a new chat. You've got you can start a new chat there. You can take that away. It feels very much like ChatGPT. You've got this workspace area. We'll have a quick look at that in a bit, and then some different. You get the list of your previous searches, etc. And you have your settings, go into that. And then up here, you've got the model that you're using, and we've got ChatGPT 4.0. But this is where it starts. You can have ChatGPT 3.5, you can have ChatGPT 4.0. Now, these Collective Insights are GPT models that have been created by the people at Whitespace, but you can create your own. You've got access to Dolphin-Llama, which is uncensored, which might be useful, Gemma, then you've got the Llama, various Llama models, Owen 2.5 Coder, Phi 3.5 Coder, and you can add additional models into the Collective. So here we've got a selection of them, and you can add different ones in. So one of the interesting things here is you'll notice these links here that says external, and these ones don't have a link on them. And that is because these are being driven by a model that sits on their server and sits on your server. If you bought this as a business, it would sit on your server, and you can manage what people have access to. So it means that you can stop your data from leaving the system. So if you use Llama, for instance, and it just stays on the system and doesn't go off the system. If you use ChatGPT, that has to make a call out of the system that you're using, and therefore it becomes more of a public thing. But this software is already being used in really sensitive areas where the data where you just don't want the data to leave the system. So if you're a business that is worried about its data being used with large language models and losing that data, or that data becoming external to your business, then this is a way of locking it down, and Collective will do that for you. So you've got the window with ChatGPT 4.0, and what you can do is sort of add another model. So if we've got ChatGPT 4.0, let's add in Gemma, and let's add in another model. Let's add in one of the Llama models, perhaps one of the locked up Llama models. So now we've got three GPTs all running alongside itself. So here we've got a prompt, and we've got ChatGPT, we've got Google Chat, and we've got Meta Chat. And I've put in a simple question: how does the honor system work in the UK? Let's have a look at what it gives us for that. Need to scooch back up to the top. So we have the ChatGPT 4.0, and as you can see, it's really quick. It's really sharp. The third one, Llama, took a little bit longer, but it did the other two very quickly. And it gives you a structure of the honor system, the orders of merit, process. And then we have the Gemma version, and it again gives you the types of honours, baronesses, viscounts. So the UK honours system was released for the New Year's honours list. That's why it's front of my mind at the moment. And then you can have your go at Llama, and again, Llama gives you a result. You see, Llama pretty detailed. Even tells you how to address people who've got a damehood, etc. Cool. Now, if you think about creating your own GPTs and being able to use multiple large language models, what you can do is get an answer, and then you can check it against the another large language model, and hopefully that helps to reduce the amount of hallucination, for instance, that you might get. So really cool access to multiple GPTs. Okay, one of the other things you can do, really good, as you'll have seen on most of my other videos, my GPT, my large language model use is a bit disorganized. So over here on the left-hand side, you can add in folders and just go along and you can rename the folder. So you could call this one UK political changes, something like that. And then you've got a folder, and then any of your previous chats, you can just drag them and drop them into them, and you can obviously add to these chats, so you can build up your knowledge and organization. I think this is, you know, for something that is absolutely frontier, this model is frontier, having that sort of use case in it. ChatGPT didn't have it for months and months and months this year. It's now just got them in as projects. The Collective has it in from day one. Really cool. Helps you to organize your life, which is great. Just going over to the main chat window. So you can, with this little plus here, you can turn on web search. And then you get this web search is enabled, this little green dot, which is very cool. And again, something that wasn't available on ChatGPT 4.0 until relatively recently, the ability to do web search, now it is available, and it's available in the Collective as well. And of course, you can upload your own files in the same way that you can do it in all of the large language models, so that you can then work on those individual files that you've got. And you can also speak to ChatGPT, which is another really cool thing. Let's try that out. Okay, so over here, you can use record a voice. So you can actually just talk to ChatGPT if you want to. So I'm going to say, give me the history of Nottingham Forest Football Club. see what we get. So it understood me well, which is nice. It's processing a number of sites. So it's chosen 25 sites to look at. It's analyzing. It gives me all of the sites that it's looked at. It has said it's usually currently using ChatGPT 4.0. It has gone through a process to decide whether any other additional models would be necessary, and it's decided to continue with ChatGPT 4.0. And here we go. Nottingham Forest Football Club, based in West Bridgford, Nottingham, England, one of the oldest football clubs in the world, known as the Garibaldis, because it's the colour of its shirt, the reds. Tricky Trees. Crowning achievements came under manager Brian Clough, Peter Taylor, when I was a child. It's got references. It's given me where the references have come from. Now, down here, you can edit it, edit this. You can copy it as normal. You can read it out aloud. You could generate an image. What generating an image? What's generating an image? You can say whether it's a good or bad response. You can continue the response. You can regenerate it. You can do a knowledge graph. I wonder what that gives us. It tells us where we got the references from. I'm sure that's working beautifully, is it? Next thing I'm going to look at is this workspace area. So you have up here, you have models and knowledge. So this is where you can add in additional models to the GPT. So you can name your model. Put an ID in there, select the base model that you want to use from it, and these are all the ones that you're able to select from right now. Put a short description in, and then write the prompt for it. So this is creating your GPT model that I've shown you videos of in the past, and what I will do is I will do a separate video on creating a GPT within Collective. You can do the prompt suggestions, and then you can attach your own knowledge base. And then there's some various filters, etc., and the capabilities. And then in here, what you can do is add in documents that the collective will draw from when it is creating its responses. Let me show you how custom GPT works with Collective. So we can go up here and we will, what I want to do is go to this Collective Insights here. So what I'm doing here is I'm using one of these Collective Insight reports, and these are GPTs that have been created by Whitespace for a specific customer that they have. So housing changes in the UK, I could add some documents in if I wanted to, but let's just see what we get. So it is looking at the web, it's gone 25, sites processed, and what this should do is produce a document that summarizes from these 25 websites that it's scraped, summarizes the issues around housing changes in the UK. And there we go, housing changes in the UK, trends, challenges, future discussions, future directions, and it produces an executive summary, an introduction, demographic change, changes in home ownership rates, shifts, tenure types, affordability issues, policy issues, emerging trends, conclusion, and it gives you the references. Now, this was specifically built for a client who wanted an output in this format. So think about how strong that could be in your business if you identify a way of producing board documents, etc. You want long detailed reports or short reports. You can set that up in Collective. And then you can put information in, or you can ask it to search the web and produce those reports for you as an addition to your strategic decision making. Absolutely fantastic. Okay, that's the Collective. Now, I think, why is this important? Well, A, it gives you access to multiple large language models. And I think in your business, that's a really useful thing to have. And it will give you the opportunity to try out some different models. I think that's really interesting and really useful. Secondly, you are getting access to a whole load of models at a reasonable cost. You're not paying for multiple models within the collective. And thirdly, and I think this is the most important point about collective, you can both create your own GPTs, so you can have things that are specific for your business, and you can run them across the business using collective. But the most important thing is you can protect your information. You can stop your information leaking out into the internet. And I think if you're a business and you've got commercially or even, you know, government sensitive information that you don't want leaking out of your business, then using a tool like collective is the way to go. So you can try this out for free. The link is down below. Go on, sign up. You can start playing with this right today. I'll be doing some more videos on collective. I will create some GPTs so that you can see how that works. I'll do some work using it as an API, perhaps with Make, etc. So I'll do some additional videos. But for now, that's the collective. Please go and have a look at it. I'm really excited about how this technology will improve. The guys at Whitespace have released this, done loads of work on it. They're working on it all the time. There'll be new upgrades, new enhancements. So what they're looking for are people to go on, have a play, give them some feedback, and then they will make sure that this interface, this software, this collective is right for your business. Okay, I've been the professor. I'll catch you soon. Bye-bye.